old UK 80s and 90s compilation albums. So let's see, can we breathe new life into some old tapes? Stay tuned, let's find out. Hello again, vinyl community and cassette community. As I mentioned, I have some British compilation albums to show you. Six of them in total. Half of them are from the 80s and half from the 90s. So let's get stuck in. These are from the seller on eBay that I bought quite a lot of stuff off of, but not tapes before. This is the first time I bought tapes off him. So let's have a look. Now, a couple of them were missing cassettes, which is a little bit of a bummer, but it's okay. Let's start off with Hungry for Hits right here. Now, this was a K-Tel compilation. Normally, I stay clear of K-Tel like the plague. I used to kind of like collecting the compilation albums on vinyl, but the sound quality was atrocious. But I thought, let's give it a go on cassette. Actually, it's not bad. The sound quality was way better than I thought. What I like about some of these compilation albums is that they have some obscure stuff on them. The big two in the UK, where Now That's What I Call Music and the Hits album. Once you start to get outside of those, you start to get some obscure stuff. You'll still get a few hits, but you also get songs that maybe barely scrape the top 40. In some cases, didn't even make the top 40. Maybe they made like the top 75 or the top 100, and just more obscure stuff that you don't often find on compilation albums. Now, as I mentioned, this is a K-Tel compilation. This was released in 1984. Would have had two cassettes. I only have cassette one. And let's have a look at the track listing. The artwork, whatever. It's got a picture of like a wolf on it. Hungry for hits, this was the only one that they ever made in this series. I don't know if there were plans to be a Hungry for Hits 2, and to make it into a series like the Hits album and Now That's What I Call Music. If those plans existed, they never came to fruition, unfortunately. But let's have a look. There are definitely a couple of highlights on here. There were a couple of songs I did not know as well. Here's the track listing, which I will read out as well. Shakin' Stevens, A Love Worth Waiting For. Believe me, it was worth waiting for. It's not a good song. Nick Kershaw, Dancing Girls. It's an okay song. It's not one of his better ones, though. Captain Sensible, Glad It's All Over. That was actually a pretty decent track. Alvin Stardust, I Feel Like Buddy Holly. The Weather Girls, It's Rainy Men. That's a classic. I'm not a massive fan, but it's a decent track. Matt Bianco, Sneaking Out the Back Door. That was actually pretty decent too. An absolute new wave classic, Heaven by the Psychedelic Furs. And then we finish off with Joe Jackson and the unfortunately titled Happy Ending. Side B, we have Feel Fear on and Galaxy. What Do I Do? The special, aka. Nelson Mandela, that's a good track. Well-known song, it's a good song. Sade, Your Love Is King, excellent track. The Gap Band, Someday. Cyndi Lauper, Time After Time, that's probably the highlight on the album. Jeffrey Osborne, Stay With Me Tonight, which it's a throwaway pop song. And Pat Benatar, Love Is a Battlefield. Not a massive hit in the UK, actually, but one of her better-known songs for sure. So that was Hungry for Hits. And I put these in chronological order, by the way. Next up from 1985 is Out Now. Now, I'd like to get part two of this. I'm currently bidding on it. We'll see if I get it. Somebody else may well outbid me between the time this video is put out and the time the auction ends, but that's okay. It's actually easy to find it on eBay. It's just difficult to find it for under 10 bucks. So I'm trying to cheap out. Anyway. So Out Now, so like I said, there was a second one, so this was a series of sorts. They didn't make more than two, but this was a compilation by Chrysalis and MCA Records. So two of the bigger record companies, not in the same league as like EMI and Virgin with Now That's What I Call Music, or Warner and CBS with the Hits album, but still, this could have been a rival. It has some good tracks on it. And it also has, again, some obscure songs. It has a couple of real kind of duds on it as well. But you know what? Some of the big boys' albums, now that's what I call music, we're hardly immune to having dud tracks as well. Here are the cassettes. Now, one thing interesting about this And indeed, the next album I'm going to show you is it comes in these double size sort of horizontal boxes. I used to hate these as a kid, and I still don't like them. I mean, I like to have it for the novelty value now, just for the nostalgia, but you can't stack them. They don't fit in cassette holders or cassette drawers like I have back here, of course, and neither do the other types of double cassettes. But you know, if you store your cassettes, let's say, by stacking them or putting them side by side, this doesn't fit either. There's just no good way to fit this into any setup, and so you just have to, I don't know, have a separate pile for these type of cases, I guess. But let's have a look at the track listing. Oh, before we do that, I like little quirky things like this. So if you see this, and if you guys can make that out, there's an old sticker in here from Woolworths, and what's nice is that it has the store number and the date. Now, Woolworth, of course, or Woolworths, the plural, as most people call it, was a chain that I'm pretty sure existed in the US as well. That's before my time here. But was kind of a staple of British culture for many, many decades. I used to love going to the store. Sadly, it closed down, was probably close to 10 years ago now. I don't know, 7 or 8 years ago maybe. It was really hit hard by the recession. Started in 2008-ish. Anyway, this store number 446/5, I actually looked that up. And believe it or not, there is an online catalog that shows the old Woolworths stores and all the store numbers. And this was somewhere in Devon, which was kind of cool. Devon being a county in England, for those of you who don't know. And it has a date on it, 8/4/85. So that would be the 8th of April, 1985. So that's kind of cool. I don't know if that's the date that it was put out on the shelf, or that's the date maybe that Woolworths received it, something like that. But anyway, let's have a look at the track listing. Track listing is right here. Now, one good thing about this one is I do like the fact that you get pictures of some of the artists. I think these are all either album. I think these are all album covers right here. It's not every artist that's on here, but it's most of them. Track listing right here, which again I'll read out. Tears for Fears, Everybody Wants to Rule the World. So we get a real heavy hitter right out of the gate. Glenn Frey, The Heat Is On. Okay. Was not actually a massive hit in the UK. It was a top 40, but it is a very well-known song. And in fact, I have to say the tape one is pretty damn good on here. Almost every song in here was a top 20 hit. Anyway, moving on. David Grant and Jackie Graham, Could It Be I'm Falling in Love. Jermaine Jackson, Do What You Do, a song that I didn't think I knew until I played it on here, and then it all came back to me. Calling the Gang Fresh. Phyllis Nelson, Move Closer, that was a number one hit in the UK. And Pat Benatar, Love's a Battlefield. There's a little bit of duplication amongst these compilation albums. Side 2, Go West, We Close Our Eyes, classic 80s song. Bronski Beat, I Feel Love. Nick Kershaw, The Riddle. I think that's a pretty good Nick Kershaw song. Another number one hit, Paul Hardcastle, 19. The Color Field, Thinking of You. David Cassidy, The Last Kiss, which is kind of a terrible song. And Sharp and Newman, Change Your Mind, which actually was pretty good. I kind of enjoyed it, Newman being Gary Newman, so I wasn't too surprised that I liked it. But now, tape two is it's kind of ropey. It's not as good. But anyway, it starts off well with Thompson Twins, Lay Your Hands on Me, and The Damned, Grimly Fiendish, which I did not know, but I quite enjoyed it. And then Billy Bragg, Between the Wars, which I did know, but only recently. I'd only recently heard that song. Then another good song, Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, Don't Come Around Here No More, which I think missed the top 40 in the UK, but it's a great song. Godly and Cream, Cry. That was a pretty big hit. New Edition, Call It Now, and Kim Wilde, Rage to Love. So okay, side three is not terrible, but it's not as good as the first two sides. And then side four, we have Let's Go Together by Change. I did not know it. Then Killing Joke, Love Like Blood. I know Killing Joke. I did not know the song Love Like Blood, but it was okay. Meat Love, Piece of the Action. Again, I think that missed the top 40 in the UK. Los Lobos, Don't Worry Baby. And then an artist I'd never heard of, but I love the name, Sal Solo, Music Anew. And somebody's gonna correct me here. Self-solo was like the lead singer. I was in another band, and it suddenly escaped my mind. But anyway, Alvin Stardust got a little heartache, and then the Kane Gang, Gun Law. Yeah, wasn't crazy about that one either. So, I actually thought this is a pretty decent compilation, and the second edition out now too, is also pretty solid as well. It has Billy Idol on it and Midgeur and Dire Straits. So we'll see. If I win that auction, I'll show it. If I don't, I'll pick it up somewhere else. Okay, moving on. The Hits Tape 8. Now I do have this on. I have this actually on CD and vinyl already, but it was really cheap. It's like a couple of bucks. I just couldn't pass it up. This is from 1988, summer of 1988. And as implied by the title, this was the eighth album in the series. And I won't go into the long history of the Hits albums. There's a lot of detail, and they went very much astray shortly after this, and they never recovered. A lot of poor marketing decisions, but anyway. This also has a lot of nice pictures in it. I think this has every artist though, which is nice. Track listing right here, which I'll read out in a second. It's in one of those fat boxes again, but or those not a fax box, I'm sorry. One of those weird horizontal boxes. Anyway, track listing. Aha, Stay on These Roads, one of my favorite Aha songs. It had no business being the lead track on here, but anyway, because it was only a number five hit. But we'll get into that in just a second. Eighth Wonder, I'm Not Scared. Michael Jackson with the Jackson 5, I Want You Back, the 88 remix. Five Star, Another Weekend. Bros, I Owe You Nothing, which should have been the lead track. It was a huge number one hit. Tiffany, I Saw Him Standing There. A terrible cover version of the Beatles classic. Taylor Dayne, Tell It to My Heart. That's a great song. Great 80s pop song. Desireless, Voyage, Voyage, or Voyage, Voyage, as they say in French. That is a PWR remix. It was also on Hit 7, but the unremixed version. Side 2, The Pasadena's Tribute, Right On. Matt Bianco, Don't Blame It on That Girl. Tasia Sevell, Love Is Contagious. Pebbles, Girlfriend. I think it was a hit in the US too. Rolls Royce, Car Wash. Whitney Houston, Love Will Save the Day. Glenn Goldsmith, What You See Is What You Get. It's not a very good song. Luther Vandross, I Gave It Up When I Fell in Love. It's not one of Luther's better ones either. Side 3 and 4, though, are excellent. Side 3, Aztec Camera, Somewhere in My Heart. Prefab Sprout, The King of Rock and Roll. I think that was the only top 40 hit in the UK. I think. Anyway. Fairground Attraction, Perfect. That was the number one. Fleetwood Mac, Everywhere. Cher, I Found Someone. That was her big comeback song. Sade, Paradise, which we're going to hear shortly, along with some other stuff. Terence Trent D'Arby, Sign Your Name, and Alexandra O'Neill, The Lovers. That's probably actually one of the weaker songs on here, but it's okay. Side 4, Eurythmics, You Have Placed a Chill in My Heart. Aswad, Don't Turn Around. Wait, was that a number one? I think it was a number two. S Express, Theme from S Express, that was a number one. Debbie Gibson, Shake Your Love. Erasure, Chains of Love. That's a great track. One of my favorite Erasure songs. Ofra, I'm gonna say her name wrong. Ofra Haza, I've never known how to pronounce it, and how to pronounce the song titles even worse. Anyway, Imnin Alu, I don't know. You guys tell me. What does that say right there? You can't even see it. Probably it's not focusing. Anyway, The Primitives, Crash, The Sisters of Mercy, Lucretia, My Reflection, and the Jesus and Mary Chain, Sidewalking. So I really enjoy sides 3 and 4 in particular on the Hits album 8. It's not the best entry in the series, but I think it's a solid one. Yeah, it's not with the absolute best, but it's pretty solid. Okay, now we're going to go into the 90s. Now that's Like Music 20. I have this on vinyl, but I really wanted to have a couple of Now albums on tape because I didn't have any, and I used to have this as a kid, Now 20. So it's very nostalgic. It's not one of the better Nows, I have to confess. As always, there's a few highlights, but what I consider to be the golden period of British Now That's What I Call Music albums would be up to and including Now 39, which was released in 1998. It was like March 98 that came out. That was the golden period, and it's been downhill since then. Now 20 is one of the worst ones in the golden period. It's probably the worst 10. But anyway, let's read out the track listing. Oh, before we do that, I'm sorry. You'll notice that it's a double album, but it's in one of these kind of cool boxes right here. I always like these. They're much easier to store. That's what one of the tapes looks like right there. Anyway, this is from 1991, so let's look at the track listing. Vic Reeves and the Wonder Stuff, cover version of Dizzy, the Tommy Rose song. Live Your Life Be Free by Belinda Carlisle. U2, The Flyer. Pet Shop Boys with the terrific Where the Streets Have No Name, cover version of the U2 song. Erasure, Love to Hate You. OMD, Sailing on the Seven Seas. Simply Red, Something Got Me Started. Lisa Stansfield, Change. And Zoe, Sunshine on a Rainy Day. Side 2, we have Salt and Pepper, Let's Talk About Sex. Color Me Bad, I Want to Sex You Up. Kenny Thomas, Best of You. And Prince and the New Power Generation, Get Off. So there's a little bit of a sex theme going on with three of the first four songs. Let's face it, every other Prince song is about sex, so I don't know. Anyway, continuing, Rosala, Faith in the Power of Love. Two Unlimited, Get Ready for This. That's a early 90s dance classic. Moby, Go. The Justified Ancients of Moo Moo. It's Grim Up North Part 1. That was, for all intents and purposes, a KLF. And PM Dawn, Set Adrift on Memory Bliss. I like that song, it's a good track. And side 3, Paul Young with a terrific cover version of Don't Dream It's Over. Enya, Caribbean Blue. Julian Lennon, Saltwater. Paula Abdul, Rush Rush. Jason Donovan, Any Dream Will Do. That was from the Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat musical. Kathy Dennis, Too Many Walls. It's one of my favorite songs of hers, I've always liked it. Alison Moyet, This House, which we're going to listen to shortly. That's one of my favorite songs on the album. Mark Cohen, Walking in Memphis, and Glass Tiger, My Town. Side 4, we have Scorpions, Wind of Change, In Excess, Shining Star, Roxette, Joyride, James, Sit Down, Voice of the Beehive, I Think I Love You. That's a cover version of the, who sang I Think I Love You? Somebody tell me, it's gone out of my mind. Anyway, continuing, we have Slade, Radio Wall of Sound. Monty Python, Always Look on the Bright Side of Life. That must have been released, or it was probably featured in a commercial or something. And Don McLean, American Pie. That's the full version of American Pie, like all 7 minutes of it, or however long it lasts. Again, that must have been in a commercial or something, and it recharted. Like, that's all I can think of. Okay, next up, let's pick this up. Now 21. This was released in 1992. I am unfortunately missing cassette 1, which is a bit of a drag, but anyway. Track listing. Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody. That was re-released after Freddie Mercury's death, I think. Yeah. Number one hit. Wet, 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 Goodnight Girl. Shakespeare's Sister, Stay. The Temptations, My Girl. Of course, that was from the movie My Girl with Macaulay Culkin. Simply Red, Stars. KLF, Justified and Ancient. Madness, It Must Be Love, it's another re-release. Genesis, I Can't Dance, and Julia Fordham, Love Moves in Mysterious Ways. I really like that track. I've always liked it. I love the piano intro to it. I don't know. Side 2, we have Crowded House, Weather With You, that's a classic. Right Said Fred, Deeply Dippy, it was a number one. Mr. Big, To Be With You, Everything But The Girl, Love Is Strange. Roxette, Church Of Your Heart. Brian May, Driven By You. The Wonder Stuff, Welcome To The Cheap Seats. Jesus and Mary Chain, Far Gone and Out. James, Born of Frustration. And The Cure, Hi. A little bit of a surprise to see The Cure on here, but a nice surprise. Side 3, Shanice, I Love Your Smile. The Pasadenas, I'm Doing Fine Now. As a cover version. And again, I forgot who did the original. It's something. Oh, I think I even have it. Anyway, someone will tell me. Kylie Minogue, Give Me Just a Little More Time. Never been a big fan. It was a big hit. It was a number 2 hit, but I've never been a big fan of that song. East Side Beat with a really, I think, terrific cover version of Ride Like the Wind, the Christopher Cross song. That's another one that we're going to listen to. Two Unlimited, Twilight Zone. KLF, America, What Time Is Love. Clivals and Cole, A Deeper Love. Opus 3, It's a Fine Day, and Erasure, Breath of Life. Side 4, we have MC Hammer and Adam's Groove. He was just calling himself Hammer by this point. Salt and Pepper, Expression. CC Penison, We Got a Love Thing. Paula Abdul, Vibology, which is a very odd song. Alison Limerick, Make It On My Own. Tina Turner, Way of the World. Curtis Steiger's I Wonder Why. And the song I should be embarrassed to like, or to admit that I like, but I do like it. Diana Ross, When You Tell Me That You Love Me. I always like the chorus to that. Okay, finally. Now 29, should be two cassettes. I only got sent one, so it really sucks. This is from 1994. And I can only tell you the track listing from the first cassette here, because I'm missing the back part of it. Now, I actually do have this on CD, so I could tell you guys the whole lot, but, you know, we're 20 minutes in already, and we got some songs to listen to, so let's wrap this up. Pat O'Banton with Robin and Ally Campbell, Baby Come Back. You know, Robin and Ally Campbell were in UB40, right, I think? Cyndi Lauper, Hey Now, Girls Just Want to Have Fun. That was a remix of the classic 80s song. Big Mountain, Baby I Love Your Way, the Peter Frampton song. Take That, Sure. One of my least favorite songs of theirs, actually. Michelle Gale, Sweetness. Wigfield, Saturday Night. I always had a bit of a love-hate relationship with that song. MC Saren, The Real McCoy, Another Night. If you saw my previous video, I got the 12-inch single of that. Corona, Rhythm of the Night, which is probably my favorite, possibly my favorite song on the entire album. It's a terrific dance song. We're going to listen to that one, too. New Order, True Faith, 94. Whisper It Quietly, but I think the 94 remix is better than the original. And Sophie B. Hawkins, Right Beside You. Side 2, we have... how do you pronounce his name? Yusuf Adur. Sorry. Featuring Nina Cherry, 7 Seconds. Lisa Loeb and 9 Stories, Stay, I Missed You. Crash Test Dummies, Louis Armstrong, We Have All the Time in the World. I think that was in a commercial, something like that. So it was re-released. Robert Palmer, Know By Now. REM, What's the Frequency? Kenneth. Oasis, Cigarettes and Alcohol. I think that's her first appearance on an album. The Rolling Stones, Love Is Strong. And finally, a definite classic, Zombie by the Cranberries. So there you have it. Those are the tapes. What I'd like to do now is to play you guys some of them. So, you know, there's copyright restrictions, so I've had to carefully pick songs that I like, but also songs that I wasn't going to get hit with a copyright strike for. Ones where the copyright holder is allowing people to play them in their videos. So, from Hungry for Hits, we're going to play Cyndi Lauper's Time After Time. From Out Now, we're going to play the Thompson Twins' Lay Your Hands on Me. From the Hits Tape 8, we're going to play Sade Paradise. From Now 20, we're going to play Alison Moyet, This House. Now 21, we're going to play East Side Beat, Ride Like the Wind. And from Now 29, we're going to play Corona, Rhythm of the Night. So stick around, you know. Maybe some of you haven't heard some of these songs, if you want to hear something new. They're on tape. I'm going to do what I can to make them sound decent. So we're going to turn the equalizer on, tinker with it a bit, you know, we'll see. I don't like using Dolby, so there may be some tape hiss, but you know what? Live with it. I live with it. I don't think it's a big deal. So yeah, please stick around. We're gonna play some music. We're gonna play some tapes. 6 songs. We've got 6 tapes, so we're gonna play 1 song from each of them. So thank you guys, as always, for watching. If you would like to subscribe or comment on this video, I always appreciate the feedback. Click on the little bell icon, and you will be notified whenever I upload a new video, 2 or 3 times a week usually. And yeah, that's it. Until next time, thank you as always for watching. Stay tuned to listen to some music, and I will see you guys soon. Bye bye.
What is this empty plane? I could be happily lost, but for your face. Here stands an empty house that used to be full of life. Now it's home for no one, and here's why. Strange body rolls and dips, I close my eyes.